Next, we turn to the page vault and ask the question, what happens when an application requests a virtual address that's not mapped to physical memory, but it is somewhere on disk? I'll represent a user's process like so, and at some point, he uses a virtual memory address that's not actually mapped to physical memory at the moment. Yikes! Actually, it's not that big a deal. An exception is raised, which sets the running process back to be ready to repeat the instruction that created the fault. Meanwhile, the operating system's page fault handler takes over to address the problem. He checks to make sure the request is actually valid and sends a segfault if it isn't. Then he loads the desired page into memory, gets everything ready, and then tells the scheduler that the process is ready to resume. The process will execute its memory move or read or whatever it is again, and this time it will succeed because the page has been loaded into memory and it can continue running. That's the high-level picture. Let's talk a little bit more about what the page fault handler does. So assuming that the page we want really does reside on disk, the first thing the page handler does is to find a physical page frame in memory to load the data into. The best scenario is that one is free. The handler keeps a list of free pages. If this is not empty, then he can just pop one off, okay? And that makes us very happy. If he doesn't have a free page, however, then he must choose a page for replacement. There are many possible page replacement algorithms. We won't go into them here. For our purposes, it suffices to say that a page handler will pick a page that it doesn't think is likely to be used soon. This page is saved to disk, and then its physical memory can store the page that was created by the page fault. So one way or another, we now have a free physical page in memory to which we can write the data we need from disk. Then we update the process's page table and any other data structures that our page fault handler needs to keep track of. And then we're ready to restart the process and let it continue on its way.